Welcome to Wednesday, and unfortunately another wet and unsettled day ahead as we take a live view from our Biscayne Bay camera in Miami right now, looking mostly cloudy and also seeing a lot of clouds around from our Key West camera. Our weather watchers up in Adams sharing views from all around town, and thanks to Deborah Perdomos for sharing this pretty and peaceful sunrise here from Fort Lauderdale. I think we all need views like this to motivate us this Wednesday. And look at this purple and pink sky courtesy of Howard Krebs in a Margate, and Melissa Gesner saying that earlier there was lightning, but that things have calmed down, and now it's just a spectacular sunrise here in Pembroke Pines. And look at all the colors in the sky here, courtesy of Center K Booth, Lauderdale by the Sea, and more of an orange colored sky as we take a look at Bridget's photo from Biscayne Bay. Now, as we look at Surfside, there are some showers that have been mainly to the south. However, throughout the day today, the rain could be impacting the search and rescue operations here, and our first responders, our heroes that have been working around the clock. I'm going to zoom on out, and you'll see that most of the rain is just to the south around Miami Beach and moving it around coastal areas of Miami-Dade County around El Portal, Little Haiti. And we've also seen the rain rolling around downtown Miami. So some of the roads are slick, and you notice some showers here around Oakland Park, Pompano Beach earlier, a heavier downpour. Now Parkland is getting soaked, Coral Springs, and across Isla Mirada, there has been some shower activity. Notice the winds are calm or light, so that would allow any showers and storms that develop to just kind of linger and hover over the same area. So that could produce some flooding if it is a heavy downpour. Temperatures a little cooler in Fort Lauderdale this morning, 73, we'll take it. 77 though in Miami, milder there, and then 81 Key West, our warmest spot. The tropics heating up, watching not one but two waves here in the Atlantic. The first of which not only has a low potential of development east of the Lesser Antilles, but check out this stronger disturbance that is midway between the west coast of Africa and the Windward Islands. The Hurricane Center is giving this a high potential of development as we head into late week and early next week. Going to be closely monitoring this. I'm going to show you some of the sea surface temperatures and the conditions here for disturbance number one. It looks like some cooler water is going to limit development. That's why the development chance is only 10%. But disturbance number two has the opportunity to stay over the warmer waters here near the Lesser Antilles and into the Caribbean. You'll notice the spaghetti plot, the model showing that it moves west northwest and could be just south of or near parts of Hispaniola and then Cuba potentially. It's still too soon to say. There are a few models that keep it moving near or in our general direction, but certainly something that we'll closely monitor, and I'll keep you updated. For today, keep the umbrella closed. Passing storms, some downpours, upper 80s, a repeat of yesterday and the day before that. The rain has been relentless. Marine forecast looking okay, no advisories, but we could see water spouts we did yesterday, scattered storms. Downpours possible because of all the moisture that's just stuck right over us. As we head into late Friday and Saturday, notice some of the red indicating the possibility of a pocket of dry air that could lower rain chance a bit. But then as we head into the 4th of July, the moisture returns, and we are really just going to continue with this high rain chance. Even through the weekend, the potential for scattered storms and highs around 90.